Welcome everybody to our walk through the Psalms. My name is Joel Povey, and today we're in Psalm 142. And in Psalm 142, it opens with this description of the Psalm, a maskil or a song of David when he was in the cave, a prayer. And I think that idea of being in a cave, obviously it was literal for David. He was running away from enemies and he was alone and hiding in this cave. And that's where this is coming from. But I think this idea that, you know, sometimes we feel like we could be in a cave, or that could be like a metaphor for where a prayer could be coming from. That was interesting to me. So feeling isolated, feeling scared or anxious, hiding, cornered, someone coming against you. This was kind of the feeling of the setting of this psalm, which I thought was interesting. So let's see what this cave prayer is all about. It says, I cry aloud to the Lord. I lift up my voice to the Lord for mercy. I pour out before him my complaint. Before him I tell my trouble, and when my spirit grows, I do this when my spirit grows faint within me. And I think these first three verses really show us what the response should be when we find ourselves in a cave, and that is to cry out to God. And I really appreciate that it says he verbally cries out, he expresses, he even maybe he literally cries, or he yells, or he verbalizes, he brings it out what's going on. I think a lot of the times I say I'm going to pray, or I think I'm going to pray, but I just kind of stay in my head. And I really, what I took from these first three verses is that I need to, whenever I'm feeling alone or kind of cornered or in the cave, I need to verbalize it. I need to get it out in prayer to God. So pray out loud. That's kind of what I got from the first three verses. And then it goes on to say, it is you who watch over my way. In the path where I walk, people have hidden a snare for me. Look and see, there's no one at my right hand. No one is concerned for me. I have no refuge and no one cares for my life. And this is a really deep loneliness that he's describing. And I think when we feel alone, when we feel like people are against us or no one cares about us, those are some deep lies. And obviously the truth that this psalm goes on to say is that you are never alone because God is with you. But often we can find ourselves in places where we feel like no one understands us, no one cares for us, no one's got our back. And especially in those times, we need to turn to God and to reach out to others who are safe too. So this is how David goes on to cry out to God about this. He says, I cry to you, Lord. I say, you are my refuge, my portion in the land of the living. Listen to my cry, for I'm in desperate need. Rescue me from those who pursue me, for they are too strong for me. Set me free from my prison, that I may praise your name. Then the righteous will gather about me because of your goodness to me. So it's looking forward to a time of hope, to a time of being connected again to people in this place of isolation in the cave. So I think that's what we need to do whenever we feel cornered and in a cave. We need to ask God for help. We need to look for hope for how we're gonna get out of that cave and see those people who are gonna help us with that. And I'm hoping that this could be helpful for you, that you could learn from this psalm, that you can pray out loud. You remind yourself that you are not alone and that you look with hope towards getting out of that cave. And who are those people who you can trust? Who are the good people in your life that are going to help you be there when you're out of the cave? Because I know from my experience and from the promises of Scripture that we are not alone. And even in our darkest and loneliest places, especially when we cry out to God, that those can be places of transformation. And it's in those times and places that we hold on to the hope to keep going, because we know we have a promise that we will not always be in a cave in despair and feeling those feelings. So that was what I took from this psalm. It's the prayer of, you know, how to get yourself out of a cave when you get there. So I hope that can be helpful for you today. And I hope you can learn to pray those kinds of prayers with David and with the Psalms as we continue to journey.
Now we pray to you, Father, for peace in the world, for the right use of all you have given, our respect for creation in us be restored. And Lord, in your mercy, we pray for the poor of the world everywhere. And And for all those who suffer from hunger and fear, for those who are homeless, for those who